Thank you very much. Thanks for inviting us to Asbury Park. We love it here and we're happy here. I'm going to let June, she'll be out in a few minutes, I'm going to let her tell all the details of it all and tell you how much we love you and all. I won't say that, I love you, yeah. But she's going to be talking to you. But this, I want to do a song and make a very special dedication on this song. I don't know if you've been told tonight already, but it's a very special night for the Vaccaros. 25 years ago tonight, Dr. Sebastian Vaccaro, Henry's father, was knighted by Pope John the 23rd. He was such a good man and a godly man that following the banquet, when he accepted this honor, he got a call from the sick and he went out after midnight and made house calls the night that he was knighted. And he died the next day. For that very special person, the late Dr. Sebastian Vaccaro, for Henry, for Henry's mother, his sister, for the whole family, we wanted to do this song dedicated to people like him who have worked so hard and given so much with their hands. These hands ain't the hands of a gentleman. These hands getting calloused and old. These hands raised a family. These hands built a home. Now these hands raised to praise the Lord. These hands won the heart of my loved one. And with they are never alone. If these hands fill their task, what more could you ask? All these fingers have worked to the bone.
History of Asbury Park would be complete without acknowledgement of the late Dr. Sebastian P. Vaccaro and the tremendous impact he had on the lives of so many people in our community. After graduating from Asbury Park High School in 1926, Dr. Vaccaro completed his medical education at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C., which conferred him the degree of Doctor of Medicine in 1932. He then served his internship at Monmouth Memorial Hospital in Long Branch and St. Mary's Hospital in Hoboken, New Jersey. In 1939, Dr. Vaccaro started practicing medicine in his hometown of Asbury Park. His office was located at 509 4th Avenue, where he kept office hours 7 days a week, Monday through Saturday, from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., and Sunday from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. On average, Dr. Vaccaro would treat up to 100 patients a day and charge a fee of only $3. In addition to seeing patients in his office, Dr. Vaccaro made house calls accompanied by his wife, Rosemarie, a registered nurse. It was not uncommon for him to return from these house calls well after midnight, and some nights not at all, when he would stay by a patient's bedside when they were seriously ill. When he did sleep, his office phone was next to his bed and his doctor's bag ready at the front door. He never refused any patient, black or white, whether they had money or not, at any time, day or night. As a result of his unending care and compassion, many of the impoverished flocked to his door. If a patient could not pay for their medication, Dr. Vaccaro would have it charged to his own account at Warner's Drugstore. There were many times during the cold winter months that Dr. Vaccaro would make a house call to one of his patients, only to discover that the heat was turned off for lack of payment. He would then call People's Ice and Coal Company in Asbury Park and charge the bill to his own personal account. Dr. Vaccaro delivered many children at their homes on Asbury Park's west side. The families showed their gratitude in numerous ways, by gifts of homemade pies, jams, and even animals such as chickens and pigs, which delighted Dr. Vaccaro's young children. One of his patients even named their son after him, Sebastian Doc Holland, an Asbury Park High School alumnus. In 1956, when Salk's polio vaccine was first introduced, it was only administered by injection and at a cost not all could afford. Dr. Vaccaro was furious at the medical society as they were charging the children for this vaccine. He stated, "The government gave us this medicine, and at least we as physicians should do is administer it for free." He administered over 1,000 free Salk polio vaccine shots to the children in Asbury Park and Howell Township school systems. When the Howell Township committee voted to send Dr. Vaccaro $100 in appreciation of his services, he would not accept the check and suggested instead that the committee donate it to charity. On October 16, 1959, at a ceremonial awards banquet at the Berkeley Carteret Hotel, Dr. Vaccaro was awarded the honor of being knighted into the Order of St. George by Pope John XXIII for his humanitarian contributions. After the banquet, he continued to place those in need above his own interests and made several house calls to the ill until the early morning hours. One patient on Borden Avenue remarked that evening, "Here comes Jesus Christ, dressed in a tuxedo." Dr. Vaccaro passed away silently in his sleep on October 21, 1959. The community that he had dedicated his life to serving returned his love and compassion by an overwhelming show of sympathy. It took all of the city's resources to deliver the thousands of flowers and manage the funeral procession, which overflowed the streets. His life is an inspiration and his memory a benediction. Dr. Sebastian P. Vaccaro, M.D., was a true modern-day knight whose legendary deeds will be recounted to future generations. He will be remembered as a man who stood firmly by his convictions and principles, who loved and served his fellow men all hours of the day and night, without prejudice, disregarding his own welfare, who exercised his profession with competence, charity, abnegation, and usefulness, and who died in the performance of his duties as a soldier would die a hero on the battlefield. In leaving us, you have left a vast emptiness in our hearts, but we will never, never forget you. You will always be with us in spirit and through the numerous contributions you made on behalf of your fellow man.